we continue to be very focused on partners. Well, that in one of the places where, in one of the technology segments where our products play, virtualization, there are other companies such as VMware, which pretty much intend to control the world. We don't have that strategy. We intend to complement our partners, specifically complement Microsoft, Intel, HP, Noble, and IBM. We're still a small company. We want to just grow, but we don't want to replace or displace our partners. We want to partner with them in a true fashion. Because of certain things which are happening with some of my companies, I tend to talk to investment bankers, and they tend to ask me for my background. As a result, I tend to pitch them as WSOC. And so I used to pitch as WSOC, and typically I would get the reaction, oh, you have virtualization, that's really cool. Oh, that question, that's not interesting. Oh, forget it. Well, it's a large market. No, go away. And then I changed the position and told them, it's not web hosting, it's web present software as a service. So what our partners are doing, they are selling web presence application and software as a service more. Well, their reaction switched to completely opposite. Oh, software as a service, that's really cool. Well, virtualization, that's okay. But software as a service, that's the coolest thing you have. Well, in any case, no matter what this guy thinks, web hosting infrastructure market is quite significant. So basically, we believe that the main opportunity for web hosting service providers to grow revenue is to offer software as a service. Well, what is software as a service? Effectively, it's a software which is deployed as a hosted service and accessed over the internet. When we started developing infrastructure for software as a service, it wasn't a real market. There was no business models, there was no success stories. By now, it's a very real market in all those different areas which are shown on the slide: email, collaboration, HR portals, ERP, web conferencing, e-commerce, CRM, web infrastructure, of course, that's software and service, web presence applications, that's you guys, online games, and traditional applications. There are players which are significant in size, which are profitable, which are growing, which have sound business models, and some of them are even very highly valued by the stock market, such as, for example, Salesforce.com. Well, here I want to talk about a little bit about something which has, have been, to some extent, something which I was surprised to understand at a certain point in my involvement with the technology industry, is that if you read general press, Microsoft is always positioned as an evil company, right? That the company which is somehow is not having good practices against competitors and so on and so forth. And, you know, it's almost like Google is positioned as a very good company. So it's like a company which is really good, it's good for users, good for everyone. Well, in reality, if you talk about Microsoft and Google for you guys, Google is an evil company. Google doesn't want anyone else to make money on whatever they're doing except for themselves. It's very opposite from being focused on partners. Quite the opposite for Microsoft. Microsoft is very much focused on partners, and so there's lots of things which Microsoft is doing which you can take advantage of. As Kurt mentioned, there are representatives from different countries in this room, over 30 countries, and I happen to talk to people in different countries about software as a service, and the perception of software as a service is completely different. So for example, if you go to China or Russia, people say software as a service. No. Nobody will use software as a service. That's completely ridiculous. And so you actually have to explain what is the benefit. So of course, the first benefit is that for the user, there is no upfront cost in buying infrastructure and buying software. But the main benefit is actually the fact that it's much simpler to use applications in this mode. In fact, end users, they don't want to buy server, network, operating system, backup and recovery software, clustering software, system management software. That's not software which they use. That's a software which is unfortunate consequence of infrastructure not being very efficient. The end users actually want to use application, which is CRM, ERP, to accomplish their business goals. And with software as a service, model, they can do just that. They can just basically go buy and use the application and not worry about anything else. So it's much simpler. For ISVs, well, first of all, it's a new market for new ISVs, and it's definitely a trend which needs to be addressed by the existing ISVs, otherwise they're going to lose their market share. On top of that, it's an attractive recurring revenue model, which is much more predictable than traditional perpetual software models. So it is a very attractive market, and pretty much every ISV right now is considering delivering software as a service mode-based applications. I think the latest example which have surprised me, for example, is that Adobe is delivering their software in software as a service mode. And I think that web hosters have this ability to A, provide an integrated offering, so you get multiple different types of applications integrated, and at the same time to be multiple choice offerings, to have different kinds of applications of the same types offered to the same customer base. And so tomorrow, and as tomorrow is happening now, web hosting companies will sell rich email, collaboration, voice over IP, web conference, and game servers, and online backup services, so some more value-added services. And we believe that by 2010, hosting platforms must be able to deliver hosted infrastructure for software as a service. And or hosted software as a service applications. Just giving you an example of what is hosted in software as a service infrastructures, we believe it's shared web hosting, which is effectively a platform where you can deploy applications, and applications are being deployed today. It's DPS hosting, it's dedicated server hosting, managed hosting, collocation. I don't actually think that collocation will change quite as much because of software as a service, but every other hosting infrastructure will change at least a little bit, because the more you put on that infrastructure, the more mission critical it becomes, the more value-added services are required to have it running, and the more customization of this infrastructure must be possible, and the more people have to be able to participate in creating the end value for the customer. And so there's two ways to offer hosted service. One is expensive way, and believe me or not, but back in 99, 2000, 2001, there were a number of companies which were able to raise money and try it to learn this model. And in this case, you will host applications and service provider location, but you will still have a dedicated infrastructure for every customer. However, it didn't really work out, and so we believe the four profitable ways to automate, virtualize, and standardize, to consolidate IT staff, data center, servers, network, and management tools across multiple customers. And if you think about our company business strategy, we do sell our software to large enterprise and to service providers. Where the strategy merges is that in the large enterprise consolidates their different departments. In the service provider space, we try to help consolidate management across multiple entities. And so virtualization impact, it allows you to put multiple applications in multiple environments, many customers on a single server. And automation impact, it allows you to reduce and improve delivery times by automating provision billing and providing good customer service. Little side note about virtualization. You know, virtualization is experiencing dramatic shift from being a non-mainstream technology to a mainstream technology this year. By now, 100% of Fortune 500 companies are using virtualization. By the way, 50 of them are actually using Virtuoso. 100% of top 25 providers are also using virtualization. Virtualization market is forecasted to double every year for the next 4 years. One of our main competitors in this place, VMware, is going public. They just filed their S1. They happen to be the fastest growing software company in the history of that size. Because of their IPOs, there's a lot of attention to this market. And I would argue that sometime in the next 2 years, your customers will prefer to buy virtualized infrastructure to buy physical infrastructure. So what's actually going to happen? The perception about virtualization will change from being something new, some new way to deploy your infrastructure. It will become a standard way to deploy the infrastructure, and physical infrastructure will still simply be perceived as legacy. I would argue that in software as a service offerings, automation becomes even more critically important. Software as a service offerings in general are more mission critical. Customers are now will depend not on, you know, how it happens with websites. I remember back in 2003, there was a web hosting company called TeacherPrice. Some of you might have remembered it. And it has experienced some very difficult development in their history. And so at some point, they had about, like, for example, 50,000 customers. At some point, they switch off the infrastructure for 3 months. When they switch it back on in 3 months, they lost 35% of customers only. Well, believe me or not, if you will switch off somebody's CRM for 3 days, you will possibly lose as many customers. And so effectively, having good automation platforms becomes much more important in more mission-critical infrastructures.